One, two, three, let's go. And you forget to just use the music, for fuck's sake. Okay, just don't mind my recordings, right, of Valkyria Profile, right? It's just was my, actually, old Let's Play, right? But, okay, again, it's RPG Legends with me, useless clown called Igor Chernov. And today I want to talk about Valkyria Profile, right? I'm just, soon we will release, I think, one of the most important games of this year, which is just Valkyria Elysium, right? And it's supposed to be part of the same franchise, right? Of the same JRPG series called Valkyrie. Because you got like Valkyria Chronicles and Valkyria Profile, actually, right? Series, right? And it's like, and two different ones, obviously, right? If Valkyria Profile is kind of serious story about Scandinavian, involved Scandinavian mythology, actually, right? And Valkyria Chronicles is kind of like anime-related story about about war, actually, right? And yeah, like, they both important, actually, right? Because it's like shame on me, actually, I never play Valkyria Chronicles, sadly, right? Myself. But I will play it eventually and will decide, actually, am I supposed to add it, actually, in RPG Legends, right? But since I played Valkyria Profile, actually, right? The whole franchise, right? I totally can just say what... that's one of the best, objectively, one of the best RPGs. And one of the most revolutionary ones also, actually, right? Because this game, what... being kinda like something like Live Alive game, what also recently been released as a remake, and been released on Nintendo Switch. And this game is extremely unique, right? If you just play with different characters and you play different story and they all just being one game and have a different gameplay at some point, right? This game is also extremely epic in a way how the people actually been, extremely innovative, actually, right? With it. So, I mean, it's like, you can create a standard JRPG like Dragon Quest. You can create something like, Final Fantasy, right? With turn-based system, right? You can create something like slightly innovative, like Wild Arms, right? With a different... with kind of bizarre world, actually, right? What being around... being a JRPG world and Wild West world, actually, right? And all these fictionaries being combined, actually, right? Create something new, right? In Valkyria Profile, they take standard tale, contain Scandinavian mythology, right? What you being a Valkyrie, right? You just being sent on a mission, right? By Odin, and gods actually rule this world, right? And you need to obey them, right? And you just a servant actually of the gods. Right? But it's kind of funny what it turns out to what this game become kind of puzzle actually, right? Because if you think it's a standard JRPG what you can just play whatever you like, it's not actually, right? Because it's extremely unique, but at the same time it's extremely easy for you to fucked up with your first playthrough, right? Because you think you got these standard mechanics, like you just have a... I mean, it's like the game is extremely unique from... I'm just starting from the beginning, actually, right? You got the extremely long cutscenes, right? You almost feel yourself like you're watching a movie, actually, right? Or some Metal Gear Solid cutscene, right? It's extremely long. It's extremely long to take you to actually have a gameplay, right? And even if you're supposed to skip it, right? And also, I need to mention, actually, what with perfect, the most perfect, port and the perfect version of this game, right? I continuously forget to mention it actually, right? In some RPG Legends episodes, right? Because for me it's extremely important for people to know the perfect version of the game, right? If you got like some ports, for example, right? Like you got like, well, for example, Final Fantasy IV, right? Different type of ports. Like you got like Final Fantasy IV, from Super Nintendo, right? GBA version, or I don't know, just 3D version, right? Or PlayStation Portable version, right? I continue to promote it, and just extremely hard actually, right? Вот almost every port, what Japanese developers have to PlayStation Portable, right? Well, almost every PlayStation Portable port a perfect one actually, right? Yeah, just Tales of Phantasia, Is 7, right? I don't know, just Valkyria Profile, I don't know, just any game from PlayStation Portable is extremely it's an aesthetic pleasure to play, especially on PC, actually, right? Because we got the perfect emulator, which is PlayStation Portable, and just emulator for the PC, actually, right? Like PPSSPP, I think it's called, actually, right? It's have a long name, actually, right? And if you start play through any PC, actually, right? Because almost any PC can emulate this game, actually, right? But it's kind of hard to recommend it actually to play it on via PC on emulator because this game also got like game breaking bugs still actually, right? So you for example got crashes, random crashes actually on this emulator, right? So I highly recommend to just play or PlayStation 1 version if you play on emulator, right? Or play the original game actually, right? From PlayStation Portable, actually, right? But how the game unique, right? It starts from the beginning. When you just play it like a regular Metroidvania game, actually, right? You got these additional elements, right? What you can use, actually, right? Across this, I don't know, just 2D platformer, stages, I suppose, right? If you can call it them like that, actually, right? So you basically play... Your regular gameplay is basically a Metroidvania, actually, right? In different locations. You can choose these locations, right? Across the world. But the world is also supposed to be kind of reminding you... This game is totally can be compared to the Demon Crest. But it's kind of funny what this game... This guy is an idiot, for fuck's sake. Are you serious? Show me the gameplay, please. What the fuck is this guy doing? Okay, it's like, and yeah, it's like, just don't mention it. It's what I showing you actually. It's just my stream actually. The guy's an idiot. Instead of showing the gameplay, he just show the transition, and this stream ends in 10 seconds, I suppose, right? But anyway, it's like, you just play, like, this game can be compared to Demon Crest, actually, right? Demon Crest kinda have this the same gameplay, right? And it's totally not supposed to be that unique, actually, right? For people who just still thinks, this game was extremely revolutionary, right? And it was extremely unique, it actually doesn't, right? Because you got the game from Super Nintendo Entertainment System called Demon Crest, actually, right? And the Demon Crest got the same gameplay, right? So you got the huge world map, right? Well, not that huge, but you got world map, right? You just basically got 2D. World map, right? And you got your character, right? And you can go whatever you want, actually, right? I mean, whatever you want. You can go just whatever, actually, right? You can choose... you can open the location, secret location. You can go to the location what just being kind of like a... I don't know, just trader hub, right? Where you can just buy some additional items, right? And same goes with this game, which is Valkyria Profile, actually, right? You just got, like, this, I don't know, just Metroidvania screen, right? Where you can just travel just between the locations, actually, right? And supposed to be 2D, actually, right? If you see an enemy, you got transition screen, right? And you got the typical JRPG turn-based combat, actually, right? But in this combat, you actually need to press buttons in certain order, actually, right? To chain the combo, right? Because it's kind of hard to describe it, but I actually can do this, right? Because you basically need to mash the buttons, actually, right? On your gamepad, when you just, play this game, right? Literally feel like you need to mash the buttons, actually, right? And that's how I think with the perfect now just the description how you play this game, actually, right? You just mash the buttons, right? At some point you realize what it's better to just have some, I don't know, just four different mage characters, actually, right? With Lynette, actually, right? Which is the main character, right? What you, well, I think almost can change, right? In this game. Well, since you play as a Valkyrie, and her name is Lynette, actually, right? The servant of Odin, actually, right? And it's like, this game is being extremely heavy on you, actually, in a way of scenario, right? Because it's have extremely long cutscenes, right? But this game is also just being an extreme aesthetic pleasure, actually, right? Because this game, if you compare it to something like Skies of Arcadia, right? If in Skies of Arcadia you got like the kind of standard story, actually, right? About evil guy who just want to just conquer the world, right? In the end. In this game, you totally feel yourself like you just play something like Metal Gear Solid, actually, right? The game, I don't know, just got the, I don't know, second bottom, right? Game got its own philosophy inside of it, actually, right? The way how we just dialogues, I don't know, just being spelled, actually, in this game, right? The way how we just characters talking to you, right? The way how we just, the way how we just, people who just write these dialogues, right? And the overall scenario is being extremely mature and decent, right? And this game, just feels like a good book, actually, right? At some way, right? And music and, I don't know, just everything in it, actually, right? Feels like a mature game. This game is extremely mature, actually, right? But above that, it's like, you totally feel yourself like you're being deceived, actually, at the beginning. Because, yeah, on the paper, it's supposed to, you're supposed to play it like on just Demon Crest, if you ever played Demon Crest, right? It's Metroidvania, JRPG, with the story, right? And elements where you can just go whatever you want on the world map, right? And you got certain mission, certain scenario, right? But you got dozens of secrets, right? It's important for you to find them, actually, right? Because this game got multiple endings, right? And most of the endings, if you just go straightly, right? Blind. It's like for RPG players who just play a lot of JRPGs, get surprised, actually, by this game. But I think what for the first time player, actually, this game is extremely hard to beat. Even on the some ending, I don't know, right? Because it's time limited, right? You got time limited actions, actually, right? Or quests, your main quest, basically. You being time limited, actually, right? Above that, you hire, I don't know, just characters, right? Since you're supposed to be a Valkyrie, right? And you need to just transcend a regular people to gods, actually, right? Or to heavens, or to Valhalla, actually, right? You need to send them to Valhalla every time, right? And you got like an strategic game between the transition of the world, actually, right? Because the world changing every time and you just transcend the characters, right? Some characters you can't transcend, right? Some characters you can't send to Valhalla, and we always just need to stay with you, right? And that's why I just call this game a puzzle. This game is a puzzle JRPG. You can call it like that, right? I'll just when at the first you think what this game is you can handle this, right? Since clean the stage, right? Or clean some level, I suppose. Complete the level, right? I'm just and which supposed to look like kind of like Metroidvanian level, right? And just go and just down, just explore the world, right? Hire new people, send them to Valhalla, continue the story, right? Buy new equipment. But way how equipment I'll just work in this game, right? Way how many secrets you are supposed to find, right? This game is extremely time limited, right? You need to just It's extremely hard to complete it and have a perfect ending, right? The true ending, actually, right? In this game, even if you use a guide, and it's not a joke. It's like, yeah, a lot of people who just do the review, they're not supposed to spoiler on this game, actually, right? Or something like this, right? But it's not a review, right? It's just my thoughts, actually, on the games, right? What I just been play through this history, I suppose, right? Or through my lifetime, I suppose, right? And I just rate them extremely high. But this game will be extremely hard for you to just complete, even if you use the guide on the perfect ending. So you must be warned, actually, right? What this game is a puzzle, right? It's not for everyone. It's not for everybody. But it's like, if we... I'll just... But you see, it's like, that's what make these games... It's kind of funny what Valkyria Profile was sold extremely well, actually, back in the days, right? And we still got a continuation of it from Square Enix, right? Because we're supposed to be a game. It's not been released still, right? But I think it will be one of the best RPGs of 2022, actually, right? Same with Elden Ring and others, actually, right? Like Live Alive, right? And yeah, it's like, this game is a huge puzzle. What you need to just solve by yourself. Above that, it's kinda hard to handle JRPG, right? Hard to just understand battle system, right? Hard to understand world, but pure aesthetic pleasure. I'm just of experienced this music, this story, and just knowing these characters, right? And reading all these dialogues, actually, right? How game looks still. This game looks extremely decent, right? Especially if you play on an emulator, right? At 4K on modern hardware. I mean, yeah, people totally enjoy original hardware, but on original hardware you will not experience this what you just experienced on the emulator, for example, right? With all these new filters, for example, right? And brand new resolutions, right? Well, compared to the 480p, for example, right? You can always just play on a regular old shitty TV, right? And get the same childhood experience, right? Or play on just digital era modern, resolution emulator. And yeah, for a lot of people it will be kinda, forbidden action to make, actually, right? But I totally recommend it for any people who still don't like emulators, at least try it, right? Sometimes, I don't know. Because, it's like, these old games like Legend of Dragoon or Valkyria Profile look extremely decent, actually, right? With modern resolutions, actually, like 1080p or 4K, actually. It's kinda, rough experience, actually, to just emulate games, right? Because it's all depending on you, actually, right? How you just... what settings you just use, right? To emulate the game. And what emulator you use, actually, right? But, yeah. But above that, Valkyria Profile is extremely, I don't know, just hard to beat JRPG. But the game itself, I'm just having an extraordinary story, right? And when you first time see the poster of the game, right, I totally feel what it's somewhat deep, actually, right? This game, in a way of scenario, is extremely deep, I think, right? You totally can compare this game to Xenogears, Enderal, Nerim, I don't know, just Planescape Torment, and others, I suppose, Terra Enigma, right? Because these games totally have something deep inside of it, actually, right? And above that, the aesthetic pleasure, I'm just playing this game in every way. In a way of music, in a way of just how the game still, I'll just look, right? Looks, actually. And it's kind of hard, I'll just... To play such a game, right? Because even if you compare this game to Demon Crest, Demon Crest is a standard Metroidvania game, right? And you're not being time limited, actually. You got bunch of secrets to unlock the special ending, for example, right? But you never been time limited, actually, right? This game will make you suffer, actually, right? If you just want to just complete it and just on the perfect ending. I can tell you that, actually, right? Even if you've been an experienced JRPG player, this game is kind of hard to beat on the perfect ending, right? You got a lot of secrets, and I just play this game. I just play this game using a guide, and in the middle of my playthrough, I just feel myself I can continue. Because it's too tough for me to do some things, right? Because at some point you need to just complete extremely, extremely hard dungeon, actually, right? But you being like underleveled, actually, right? And some fights you need to skip. Sometimes you just need to just handle the enemies, right? But it's like you also need to use a special Dragon Slayer sword or weapon, I suppose, right? What basically one shot, actually, on just enemies, right? And yeah, for the experienced speedrunners or players who already play this game, it will be kind of easy, actually, for them to just say something like, well, this game is not that hard, right? But I can tell, if you are a casual gamer, actually, right? This game not for everyone, right? But if you give it a chance, it will be one of... You know, just this game, what you can call diamond in the rough, actually, right? This game is tough to beat, actually, right? On the perfect ending. But it's totally deserve it, actually, right? To play it. Because, it's like, the story of this game... why you being driven, actually, right? And you continue to push yourself forward to complete this game, right? You totally want to just know the end of the story, actually, right? What will happen to certain characters, I suppose, right? You totally like the story itself, actually, right? And it's you got the same effect, and you can compare also this game to the Metal Gear Solid, actually, right? You can dislike the gameplay of Metal Gear Solid, right? But in some way, right, you just want to just complete it, because you totally in this story of a Solid Snake, actually, right? And I mean, this music, one of the best adaptations, right, of Scandinavian mythology, actually, in gaming, right? Because recently they released God of War Ragnarok, right? Or you got games like God of War, original God of War, right? What just been played around в Greek mythology, right? Or Scandinavian mythology, right? But this aesthetic feeling of playing, game, what being around like Scandinavian mythology, it's all in this music, right? What being playing right now, right? It's sorrow actually, right? If you ever read the Scandinavian mythology myths actually, right? Or any Scandinavian myths actually, right? It totally, watch some anime, like Vinland Saga actually, right? This story is all about the sorrow actually, right? It's all about the regretting, I don't know, just, and regret actually, right? What it start with, it's like with some people evading your homeland, right? But it ends up with everything is fucked up and people are fucked up actually, right? And we're regretting what we're doing this actually, right? And you totally feel it actually, right? Inside of these myths actually, right? And you just feel yourself like you just you play something like Planescape Torment, right? It's all about regret, right? In some way the people inside of this story, right? The gods actually, right? And the Valkyrie, Lenet, right? She totally understands that she do something not good actually in her past, right? And this crushing feeling of having a regret is the most important feeling of our lives actually, right? Of the humanity itself, of any being itself actually, right? What you being entirely wrong, right? Your past was wrong actually, right? And to be perfectly honest, our entire lives will end up tragically, right? Because we all end up dead actually. We all will die eventually, right? Sooner or later, right? And the most important thing what we have to do actually in this existence, and it's not doing some stupid mistakes actually, right? Of the past, right? But we continue to doing them. It's not like we are supposed to do it, right? But some people actually, right? Who never learn, right? Or some beings would never learn, right? Even if it ends up of the apocalypse of the humanity, right? Sooner or later, I suppose, right? Some other beings will come out, actually, right? And will try to do same things what humans actually try to do, actually, right? It's push forward their own civilization and their own ambition, right? And you see, it's like, that's what this game is all about, actually, in a way of philosophy, actually, right? It's like some gods, actually, right? Or some creatures, actually, right? Try to push their ambition, right? And you just serving them, right? At some point, right? And they're being extremely strong, but it's like, and you need to overcome them, right? Because this world being ruled by idiots, actually, right? And it's totally, you can totally compare this to the real world, actually, right? You got Odin, right? God, actually, right? What kind of supposed to be kind of decent, I don't know, at the beginning, right? Become total, I don't know, idiot in the end of the story, right? And in the middle of the story, you see the Lenet, actually, right? The Valkyrie. Just simple Valkyrie who just riot against the gods, right? And just want to just, become a human being again, actually, right? And feel, the simple human being, feelings, like love, regret, right? And redemption, right? And at some point when you learn the deeps or how deep the story is, right? It's totally worth it actually to just play it, right? And complete it on the best ending possible actually, right? And end up with and end the game end the game experience is complete the game with true ending actually, right? But to do this, you need to solve just extraordinary big puzzle, actually, right? Just what represent what would be in, this game being a representative of world puzzle, actually, right? Because this game is a huge puzzle, actually, what you need to solve, right? Above that, you got like just regular JRPG fights, actually, just kind of tough fights at some point, right? But when you occasionally learn just how a battle system works, because this game totally just not something else, actually, right? You can compare this game to anything you ever experienced, right? This game is extremely unique. A continuation of this game is extremely unique, right? Like, because this game got a continuation, the scenario continuation, which is Valkyria Profile 2 from PlayStation 2, actually, right? And it's supposed to be some sort of a prequel, right? Of this game, right? And they're totally being connected, right? And you got like two different types of Valkyries, right? Or even just more types of Valkyries, right? Because it's all about the Valkyries, actually, right? What's supposed to just transcend and being the servant to the gods, right? But at some way, right? They riot against the gods, right? And try to just do things their way, right? And you totally understand what doing things your way at some point, right? It's better than to just follow some ruler, I suppose, right? Because, again, this world being ruled by idiots, right? Even some platforms like Twitch or Twitter, right? Or YouTube, right? Who randomly ban people for no reason, right? You don't really understand what it's censorship, right? And these platforms are just ruled by idiots, actually, right? Who just don't care about like what people just really put their soul, I suppose, right, inside of the content what they actually create, right? For example. But it's not about the but overall, it's not supposed to be. I'm not talking about the game itself right now, obviously, right? But it's anyway supposed to be my series of videos, so I can just talk whatever I like, right? But overall, RPG Legends, again, right? My personal, salute to any person who just achieved or done or just create this type of game, actually, right? And actually, it's kind of funny what this game back in the days sells extremely well. People report when this game was released, actually, right? The original PlayStation 1 game, actually, right? Because originally it was released on PlayStation 1, right? It was a huge success, actually, right? In the way of money. And it's kind of a big question for me, actually, how this type of game, actually, right? Extremely hard to beat, right? Extremely hard to beat just on the PS... Well, but you can just say what old school JRPGs are supposed to be kind of big and contain a lot of secrets, right? I'll just take example like Tales of Phantasia, right? Complete this labyrinth, actually, in Tales of Phantasia, right? Just one of the optional dungeons in this game. It's kind of rough experience, actually, right? Especially for the first timer. And I totally understand why Western RPGs try hard to be simple, actually. And try hard to have a journal, to have a log, right? Of events, right? If you somewhat, stop playing, right? And continue to play after a month, right? You at least understand what you need to do, actually, having a journal, right? If you stop to play in the middle of Valkyria Profile and just return to it after a couple of months, right? You have no idea what to do next, actually, right? Because that's how it is. And you need to just complete a lot of additional stuff. You need to just do a lot of additional things, actually, to complete this game, right? You got a lot of secrets, right? And you need to just, transcend certain amount of people, actually, right, to Valhalla, right, certain characters what you need to send, right, and certain characters you need to just have in your party, right, and you're not supposed to ever, right, send them away, actually, right, and you got these huge cutscenes, right, which just take you, like, 30-40 minutes, actually, 20 minutes, right? To, well, again, not 30 minutes, I think. I mean, but it takes you extremely long, actually, right? To watch the cutscenes, right? You don't really can compare this game again, right? To Metal Gear Solid. Way how long it takes, actually, to watch a cutscene in this game, right? It's just, you totally feel yourself like you're watching a movie, actually, not playing a game. For some people it will be kinda, it will be kinda hard to actually, to actually play it, right? And to understand this game, right? But we all know what RPG genre is the best genre of computer games, right? And only decent people, let's be honest, right? Play RPGs most of the time, actually, right? Most decent people play something like Call of Duty, right? Or Dota, right? Decent people obviously play RPGs, right? And yeah, totally deserve to be in RPG Legend list. Valkyria Profile, right? It's like, it's kind of hard for me to just afterwards play something like Valkyria Elysium, right? Maybe it will be better, actually, just compared to Valkyria Profile, right? But the whole series, like Valkyria, actually, right? This Valkyria, not Valkyria Chronicles, again, right? Totally deserve your attention, actually, right? Entire series, right? It's not like it's supposed to be somewhat like Drakengard, right? It's kind of hard to play still, actually, right? But it's like... I still not just being, RPG snob myself, right? Even if it's kind of hard to play the game, right? And it's not aged well, you anyway continue to play it, actually, right? Again, it's kind of hard to compare Valkyria Profile to Drakengard, because Drakengard, the entire series, it's still kind of rough, actually, you know, just to play it, right? Like, the first game, Drakengard 3, right? Even Nier Automata, actually, right? But Nier Automata, my personal opinion, is not a RPG, it's a slasher, actually, game, right? Even Nier, Replicant, right, got the more RPG elements, compared to Nier Automata, for example, right? But this game is, experimental puzzle RPG, not for everyone, right? But totally deserve to be in RPG Legends. The way how unique this game is, the way how the music catch with Scandinavian myths aesthetics, right? And the sorrowful feeling, to read and experience with Scandinavian myths, actually, right? And it's like this unique atmosphere what this game formed, right? Totally deserve to be in your list and to... And to be in any RPG list, actually, right? One of the best RPGs in history. It's Valkyria Profile. Totally deserve to, again, to be in RPG Legends, right? It was me, the guy who about everything but not the game, right? Itself. But, the whole point of this list, which is RPG Legends, is just to put bestest RPGs, right, in this list, and for somebody who just ever discover this genre, actually, right, and love it, as us, right, we people who already love RPGs, right, and trying to find something new, I hope it will be kind of useful to you, this information, what I deliver, actually, right, so that's it. RPG Legends, Valkyria Profile, and me, the guy, like, nobody will remember me, right?